know what is really, really weird? I think I actually get it. I get why the Arizona Coyotes were so, so high on Victor Soderstrom at last year's 2019 NHL Entry Draft. Now, normally, this kind of video, this exact format, where we talk about a player who was drafted a year ago, catch up with him, and discuss what's next for him, this would normally be branded as a 1 year later kind of video. And I'm still gonna do that, I'm still gonna put it into the playlist and everything, but the thumbnail, the title, it's gonna be a little bit different. Mostly because this prospect, drafted by the Arizona Coyotes 11th overall at last year's draft, has proven to me that I think he honestly kind of deserves the consideration that his team showed when they drafted him all the way back in June of 1 year ago. Today we're talking about Victor Soderstrom, and the biggest thing that comes to my mind whenever I think of Victor Soderstrom is what John Chayka said immediately after the 2019 NHL Entry Draft. Now, for context, Soderstrom was a right-handed Swedish defenseman. He wasn't big, but he was already a guy playing in the SHL as a solidified defender, getting minutes every night, and he was supposed to go somewhere in the top 14. The draft rankings over here from ISS had him at 14, future considerations at 11, hockey prospect at 13, McKean's at 10, 14 at TSN and Bob McKenzie. You understand what I'm talking about here. However, there was a little bit of concern as to whether or not teams in the top 10 would drive for a Soderstrom because he was a right-handed defender. Now, we did see a right-handed defender in Moritz Seider jump up to 6th overall for Detroit. But there was speculation as to whether or not Soderstrom would do so as well. At the end of the day, he didn't. He went 11th. The Arizona Coyotes actually traded up to get Victor Soderstrom. They traded with the Philadelphia Flyers, who had the 11th overall pick. The Flyers selected Cam York 3 picks later. But Soderstrom was a guy who a lot of people, once they saw the trade and the draft pick, were like, okay, why the heck did Chayka trade up for this guy? Do they really believe in him that much? And we talked about this in the video a year ago, but yes, they did. John Chayka said in the interview immediately after that Soderstrom was actually third on their draft board entirely, meaning that their draft board went, assumingly, number one, probably Jack Hughes, right? Number two, we could assume it was Kaapo, Kakko, and number three, Victor Soderstrom. It appears that they had Soderstrom above guys like Bowen Byram, above Alex Turcotte, above Cole Caulfield, above Trevor Zegras, and above all the other players in the NHL entry draft that year. And once that quote came out, everybody was like, what the heck? They had Soderstrom third on their board? Are you kidding me? Seriously, number three. If the Coyotes drafted third overall, they would have taken Soderstrom, no questions asked, huh? What? But a year later, oh boy, a year later, I think I can see why. Now, I'm going to start off this dive into Soderstrom by saying my own two cents. I believe that today, 1 year from the draft, out of all 2019 drafted defenders, Victor Soderstrom is the best. Now, that is today. That is not a year from now, that is not 2 years from now, that's not 3 years from now or in their primes when these players are supposed to be 26, 27, 28. That is today. Because aside from Moritz Seider, I can't really see any other defender who was able to excel at such a great rate compared to what he did at the previous year, aka his NHL draft year. Victor Soderstrom is a guy who wrapped up his second full season in the SHL, and he graduated from what was just a young 17, 18-year-old D-man playing for the Brynäs IF into a very legitimate top four defender that was used in the big minutes and that was relied upon heavily. You could see this in his point production. He went from 7 points in 44 games in his draft year to 16 points in 35 games in his draft plus one. Let's take a look at the Dauber Prospects report from March 2020 to go over this a little bit more. While his 5 goals and 16 points in 35 games, that was at the time, don't jump out at you, The SHL is a defensively minded league. Brynäs struggled as a team, missing the playoffs and finishing with the sixth worst offense. And Soderstrom is still very young. He played huge minutes for Brynäs, and a good case could be made that he was legitimately the team's best defender on a night-to-night basis, despite the fact he played most of the campaign as an 18-year-old. Now, the first part of this scouting report says that he had a great World Juniors. Yeah, he did. He had a really good World Juniors. He had 6 points in 7 games played for Team Sweden at the World Juniors as an 18-19-year-old. Certainly not bad. He was just under a point per game, but the game that he does play, well, that game isn't really something that is super inclined on producing points. Soderstrom is a two-way guy at heart who can shut things down in his own zone and move pucks up ice with efficiency and fluidity for his own team to capitalize on up the other way. He's supposed to be a good top four, maybe a top three guy, and he was always projected to be that. It's just the low ceiling kind of put people in a position where they said, okay, I don't know if I would take this guy in the top 10. It appears, though, that the Arizona Coyotes did indeed have that opinion, and here's kind of why. 1 year removed, let's take a look at all the other D-men that were drafted in this draft. First up is Bowen Byram, who took quite a hit to his point production, especially when compared to what people thought he would have been able to do. Byram this season was told by the Vancouver Giants, okay, stop that, you're good at producing points, we know that. This season we want you to work on your defense. That's what the main focus is this season. Who cares if you're not a point per game? We want you to go out there and show to us that you can be a good, solid defender. As a result, this year for Bowen Byram was more of a work on your kind of skills kind of year. Not really a year to progress forward, but a year to max out everything else in your portfolio before taking that next step. Next up, it's Moritz Seider, who did make the transition over to the AHL and who was very good. I will give him that. There is no fault in what Moritz Seider was able to do. It's just that the SHL, in my opinion, is a much more difficult league to succeed in the way that Soderstrom did compared to how Moritz Seider was doing in the AHL, which is a development league which focuses on developing players. Next up, it's Phillip Broberg, who straight up did not have as many points, nor the point production that Victor Soderstrom did. Phillip Broberg in this most recent season in the SHL, as another 18-year-old guy, put up a pretty not-so-great 8 points in 45 games. Now, as a guy who most people tout as an offensive defenseman, this is not great. And we've noted the problems with Broberg's game in the past that limit him from really showcasing his offensive ceiling. So, next up, it is Victor Soderstrom. After that, it's Cam York. I think that Soderstrom had a better year than Cam York. Next up, it's Ville Heinola, who was up and down a little bit. I will say that he was really successful when he was with the Jets, but that was a really small sample size, especially compared to the rest of his year, which was spent mostly in the SM Liga, where he wasn't too amazing. So, when you're John Chayka and the Arizona Coyotes, and you say that you would take Soderstrom over a Bowen Byram, over an Alex Turcotte, over a Trevor Zegras, what you're doing is you're not only betting on the long-term future of a guy like Soderstrom, because there is probably a top 3, top 4, maybe a top 2, max out of a ceiling for this kind of player. This is different from Bowen Byram, who people say could be a top 2 guy in the future. But what you're also doing is you're building towards the short-term future as well. That is something that the Colorado Avalanche, the Bowen Byram selecting team, don't need to do. Because in the Coyotes' mind, they would rather have 15 years of a good defender in Victor Soderstrom than 3 years of a player not being on your team and 11 years of him being amazing. Because the Coyotes still want to do things this season and next season. Soderstrom is on their Black Aces list. He'll probably get some time to play with the Coyotes in the play-in series. The Colorado Avalanche don't need to do that. They don't need a guy like Bowen Byram to be ready as soon as he can because they're already really, really good. So that's where the priorities lie when the Arizona Coyotes say that they would rather take Soderstrom over those other D-men. And the way that he played this past season, controlling the play, excelling as one of the best defenders on his team every single game, to me says that if I had to build a team today, one hockey team to play one game today and only today, I would rather have Soderstrom than Byram. I'd rather have him than Broberg. I'd rather have him than Seider. So that's why I think that John Chayka may have had a point. I hope you enjoyed this video, so that's Trolls99, and bye.